But before that, first time performer, bringing some comedy. Give it up, everybody, for Robin Pate.
So for a while I was known for running a movie theater. My girlfriend at the time was weird about possessives. I'd say mine, she'd say ours. I'd say hers, she'd say ours. So our girlfriend didn't like that I worked there 7 days a week. And that's the only reason she wanted me to quit. It's not like iPhone auto-type where it guesses words you've never used with anyone. You're like, how'd you guess I was going there? I've never gone there before. And then you put it in writing. Not like that. She clearly said, to my face, that's why she wanted me to quit. So my assistant manager lost his key. We shared one for a bit. Money's in the safe, cash drawer's in the office. He picked up the key to open the next day and left. I almost didn't open that last theater door. Earlier that day, I was replacing the light above the theater where it shows the theater number and the movie playing. My hand slipped, twisting the bulb, and I was shocked off the ladder. Laying on my back, wind knocked out of me. My first thought, no one should lay on this carpet. I feel fluids absorbing into my clothes. It feels like a symbiote minus like turning into venom, but just as dark. So I no longer care what's in that theater. No theater, I'm not mad at you, I'm through with you. Fast forward to me opening that door before turning off the lights and going home. A man pops out with a gun, duct tapes my wrist, and starts grilling me about money. Now, as you heard, all the money was locked up, and the one key to open them all had Frodo'd away. I was calm, polite, believable, I made it out. Dealing with parents who want refunds for movies they watched all of because the surprise villain at the end made their kid barf in the front bushes prepared me to reason with this man. I walked through everything with the cops. They asked me to go to the station the next day for a lie detector test. I agreed. They said, good, we feel better about your story now. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize it was story time. Here I thought it was after 11 p.m. on a Tuesday, and I was still at work. Like, how bored did I look? Like, I'd rather be getting last-minute discount tacos than hanging with the cops. Like, seriously, like, did my red face make it look like I was embarrassed that the cops were here? Like, it wasn't a house party noise violation. Like, I was at work, and I called them. And seriously, like, you could, like, just looking at my wrists, looking at my face, like, you could tell this wasn't a story. Like, I was so red, I looked like a body double from 50 Shades of Grey. So, the owner calls the cops. He gets it in his head that it's this scam to get free security equipment. I said, that makes no sense. He starts to explain. I say, no, I get the scam. There's a camera above the lobby. Like, no one knows it isn't recording. It's like red light intersection cameras. Half of them didn't have film in them. You still slammed on the brakes just in case. Plus, I was salaried. That ordeal didn't earn me any overtime. It lowered my hourly wage for that pay period. That's insult to injury. Like, what could I possibly need footage of so badly? Just to find the catcher keeps burning the popcorn? One of my workers called out the next day because they bit their tongue. That's a tough one to swallow. I was there the next day to close. I had someone wait with me, which was more frightening than it needed to be, because I'm on edge, right? Deja vu, spidey senses tingling everywhere. I think all the guests have left, so I go to clean a theater. He decides to go outside. I'm downstairs. I hear the front door slam. Flip, flop. Flip, flop. Flip, flop. I was way too hopped up on Red Bulls and discontinued barbecue Hot Pockets to process that correctly. I go to pick up our girlfriend from school. So we can talk about it, right? Mid-conversation, she goes, "See, that's why I told you to quit that place." Really? Really? She can still tell from my wrists that I had to do the Magic Mike of duct tape dances to get free after the gunman left. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm cut up. Plus, I had these gun muzzle bruises all over me because he was jamming me out of frustration. They looked like the ringworm you get from loving a litter box kitten too much. And she turned all of this into a BS I told you so. So I'm leaving. She goes, "Okay, no," and grabs me. She goes, "It's like when I see someone ordering Chick-fil-A drive-thru on a Sunday." Okay? "Well, they're closed on Sundays." "Yeah." "So I'll pull up and start clucking." "Huh? If my girls are with me, we all cluck." "What?" "Yeah, they pull up and they're like, 'Oh my God, there's no line, this never happens. I know what I want.' Hello? Hello?" Then they remember, it's closed. Embarrassed, they're looking around to see if anybody saw them. Then I start clucking. So I can turn this around. Wow. My takeaway, instead of "I told you so," I would have preferred clucking. Honestly, if we were sitting in this car, having this conversation, I said I was held up at gunpoint, and your only retort was to lean in, chef's kiss. She goes, "What do you know? You've never clucked at anyone." True. But I don't need to look into the eyes of a confused drive-thru patron while I angry chicken at them to know I have not improved their day. But I hope I've improved yours. I'm Robin. You're awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you, Robin. Robin Pates, everybody. Robin Pates. Coming back to the stage. Bring a little comedy. Give it up for Robin Pates. Woo!
Ride at Universal Studios, it didn't matter, they have a musical now. Does anyone remember Back to the Future 3 with Clint Eastwood? How about American Tail with Feivel Mouskowitz? Unforgiven, Legends of the Fall, Maverick, Desperado, Tombstone? If you wanted an early 90s movie to succeed, to have some box office giddy-up, you had to go out west. If you wanted a children's story to succeed, you had to go south, real quick. Has anyone read a children's story recently? They're terrifying thoughts with pretty pictures. Like, let's start. So, Little Miss Muffet, she had her cottage cheese snack ruined by a begging tarantula. Old Mother Hubbard, she had the barest cupboards in the land. It looked like she was about to fumigate. Her hungry dog was so hungry, he played dead, convincingly. Little Red Riding Hood, she was walking through the woods when a big bad wolf in sheep's clothing started hitting on her, talking about her eyes driving him mad and lips luring someone bad and holding her when she gets to Grandma's place. Woof. Jack wanted love from Jill, so Jack waited on a hill. When he realized that Jill ghosted him, Jack fled, fell, and smashed his head. Hansel and Gretel, they ran away from an abusive stepmother into a candy house trap funded by a blind cannibal witch. So Hansel held on to a dead kid's finger bone, while Jill shoved witchy poo into an oven. Sleep tight, pumpkin. You want me to leave the lights on for you? I love it. This guy rocks. Thank you, everyone. Dave.
Awesome. Awesome.
Pull out. There we go.
Yeah, pull out.
Give it up one more time. That's Robin Pates featuring Dave Gilman.
Dave.